In today's tutorial, I'll teach you how to make a simple cutscene camera just like the one you see on screen. So, let's get started. Alright, let's get started by inserting a part into our workspace. I'm going to create a different color for this part just so it's easier to see like that. And now you have to find the front surface of it. Now it's pretty easy, you can just add in a texture, and as you can see, the part that's highlighted is the front. If your part isn't face to front, you can always go into face and select that a front. That's how you can confirm that that's the front of your object. Once you've confirmed your front of the object, I'm going to scale this thing down so it's not as big. And there we go. This looks a bit better. Now delete this. And let's go rename this to camera 1. Just like that, so we know this is going to be our first camera. And let's move this to the position that you want. Now remember, the front of the camera is where your camera is going to look out of. So let's move this down like that. I want it to look in this position. And then let's duplicate this and move it to your next position, which is going to be right here for me. And let me just do that so it looks easier. Or it looks better, not easier, that didn't make sense. And I'll move this out a bit further. Just play around with your camera, depending on where your scene is going to be or where you want your camera to be looking at. Make sure that those cameras are in those positions. Alright, now what we can do is inside of our Sarge UI, let's insert a local script. Inside this local script, we have to do is we're just going to wait a second for everything to be, for the game just to load slightly, which this is long enough. This works. If your cutscene's not working properly, just play around with this value. That should fix your cutscene not working. Anyways, local tween service. I'm going to go capital tween service. It's going to be equal to game colon get service. And we're going to want to get tween service. All right. Now let's get our camera. So local camera is going to be equal to workspace dot current camera. And now we're just going to go with our local cut. Let's call this cut scene. I can't spell scene. Time. And that's going to just be equal to, let's go with 5 seconds. This is just how long you want your cutscene to last for. Which actually, let's not do that. We don't really need that at all. Alright, so local tween info. Tween info is going to be equal to tween info. New, since we're going to be creating some new tween info. Now let's just go with wait 20, or actually let's just write down 20, not wait. Now this is going to be our cut scene time. I can't spell time right. So your cutscene time is going to be, for me, I'm going to do a 5 seconds. Now these are just little notes. As you can see, I put in these two dashes. And now let's drop a line and let's create our easing style. So enum.easingStyle is going to be any of these. Now I'm going to just do sign, but you can choose any of those. Now this is going to be easing style. All right, and let's go enum.easingDirection. We have three options. We have in, out, in, and in. Or in. We have in, out, in, and out. I'll do in-out. And this is just our easing direction. Alright. And now this is going to be our repeat. So if you want your thing to repeat, you're going to want to set this to however many times you want this to repeat. So for example, if I wanted this camera to repeat 10 times, then put down 10. But I don't want mine to repeat. Or if you want yours to repeat infinitely, just do -1. But I don't want mine to repeat. And now let's go false. And this is going to be if a camera reverse. And right here, I'm just going to go and put in camera. There we go. And then this is if this is your delay. So this is how long your cutscene is going to last for. And this is your delay for your cutscene. So if you want your cutscene to be delayed by like 20 seconds. you're going to put this in. And that's perfect. Now we're just going to set our camera dot our camera type, and we're going to go enum.camera type, and we have to set this camera to be scriptable so we can script the camera instead of it just being the default camera that the player has. Anyways, camera dot cframe is equal to game dot workspace dot current. Nope. It's going to be equal to not work game, but we'll just go workspace dot camera one. And we have two camera ones, as you can see, so make sure to rename your second camera, camera two. Or is it? Yeah. So this is your first camera, this is your second one, because what our camera is going to do is it's kind of going to tween like, it's going to tween like that, right? So make sure that this one's set to camera two. Perfect. So now let's just go local tween, and it's going to be equal to tween service colon create. All right, so we're going to create something. So let's go get our camera. Now let's get our tween info. And now we're just going to tell the game where we're tweening to. So we want to tween to the position. We want to tween to the same C frame of this camera. So inside of here, let's go. C frame is going to be equal to game, or actually not workspace, is easier, dot camera 2. Now if you're wondering why I'm doing workspace, like game dot workspace, is that this is just shorter and more compact. So workspace dot camera 2 dot C frame. Alright, and now we just set up, we're just telling the game that we want our new C frame to be this C frame, so it's just going to tween there. Alright, now that's it for that that's it for this part. Get all these brackets, and down here let's just go tween colon play. And if we hit play like that, as you will see, of course we get an error. Unable to assign dot C frame. Alright, I forgot to put dot C frame there. I'll put a note in the video. But anyways, as you can see, our camera works. Now, the reason it fell down is because we didn't anchor our parts. Can't believe I did that. That was a very dumb mistake. Okay, now that we're done with all the errors, you should see that we tween perfectly fine. Alright. Now, if you don't want to see these red cameras while you're tweening, just go into their properties and just do invisible. And now you won't be able to see them, and your camera will tween nicely. And you can play with those values inside the script that I showed you. Anyways, that'll be it for this tutorial. If you enjoyed, make sure to subscribe. And you can always play around with these values to get your desired cutscene. Alright, so thank you for watching. Make sure to subscribe. And I'll see you in another video. Goodbye.